Welcome to the EA Sports 2010 FIFA World Cup penalty kick taking basics tutorial. Let's go over everything you need to know to be a prolific scorer from the penalty spot. The two most important decisions you'll need to make as you prepare for a penalty kick are where you want to place your shot and how much power you want to get behind it. First, let's take a look at the power. To power up a shot and start the runner, press and hold the circle button. The faster your shot is, the more difficult it will be for the goalkeeper to read the trajectory and react to the shot. Fast shots also have the advantage of making it harder for the goalkeeper to keep the ball out of the net, even if they manage to get a hand on it. The more power you put behind a shot, the more error it will have though. So be careful when deciding to blast one, as overpowering can result in missing the goal altogether. Instead, you can choose to press and hold the R1 button when powering up to take a finesse shot with the inside of your foot. Finesse shots are not as powerful as laces, but will have less error. But simply learning how to control the power of your shot will not be enough to beat the best goalkeepers in the world. In order to be a prolific scorer from the penalty spot, you'll need to learn how to place your shot away from the keeper's reach. Let's look at how to place your shot using the new completely analog aiming system. By default, you start aiming at the middle of the goal. From the moment you press the circle button to start powering up for a shot, you can hold the left stick to move the aim anywhere inside the goal. The more you hold the left stick in any particular direction, the further your shot will go in that direction. Be careful with how long you hold the left stick, as letting go too soon will result in a shot closer to the middle of the goal, and holding it for too long will cause you to miss the goal altogether. Make sure you practice some penalties by going into practice mode before going into a match. You'll be able to toggle the aiming system on and off by pressing the L2 button. This will reveal how fast the aim moves, so you get familiar with the new analog system. There is no bigger stage in football than the FIFA World Cup. Even the most masterful strikers of the ball have succumbed to the pressure and tension of taking a penalty kick when the eyes of the entire world and the hopes of a nation are resting on their shoulders. So, no matter how much you practice your penalty kicks, it will count for nothing if you're not able to compose yourself before starting your run towards the ball. Just beneath the power bar, you will see the new composure meter for penalty kicks. Green and yellow sections are your composed sections, while the red part of the bar represents the not composed section. To take the kick accurately, you must stop the oscillating needle inside the composed section. If you miss, the further you are from the middle of the bar, the more error your shot will have. The needle will stop the moment you press the circle button to start powering up for a shot. The size of the sections is tied to the player's penalties attribute. Successful players from the penalty spot will have bigger composed sections, giving you a greater sweet spot and therefore more room for error. The speed of the needle will depend on a variety of factors, including game difficulty, how critical the penalty is, and how far into the tournament you've gone. To the EA Sports 2010 FIFA World Cup penalty kick saving tutorial. Let's look at all you need to know when attempting to save a penalty kick. To move the goalkeeper on his line, use the left stick. To dive, use the right stick. You can choose to dive right, bottom right, left, and bottom left. For shots that go down the middle, just under the bar, you'll need to hold the right stick up to jump for these. Depending on what you think the kick taker is going to do, you might decide to commit to a safe direction early, or wait until the ball is kicked and try to react to the shot. Committing to a safe direction early will allow you to reach further and save shots closer to the corner of the goals. However, if the kick taker decides to do a stutter shot, you might be able to pick up on your safe direction as the goalkeeper starts to lean that way before launching the save. If you think the kick taker is going for placement rather than power, you can try to react to the shot by holding the right stick in any direction after the ball has been kicked. These reaction saves will not give anything away to the kick taker, but do not reach all the way to the posts. You will notice that the goalkeepers will try to save any shot if the ball is near their body by adjusting their hands and legs during the dive. Goalkeepers with better reflexes will be more successful in using these adjustment saves to keep the ball out of the net. Controls tutorial. Two button controls is a controller configuration option that will allow you to play a match simply by using two buttons and the left stick. You can select it by scrolling through the different presets in the controller configuration screen. Now let's get on the field and show you how it works. To move your player, simply move the left stick in the direction you want it to go. Depending on the situation, the game will decide what speed the player should move at. If you ever want to force your player to sprint, you can do so by pressing and holding the R2 button. Similarly, when defending, you can make your player jockey by pressing and holding the L2 button, or do running jockey by pressing and holding the R2 button and L2 button. To pass the ball to a teammate, press the X button. The game will analyse the situation and decide if it should be a ground pass or a through ball into space. If you want to play a lob pass, you can hold down the button longer. Powering up more than 80% of the power bar will play a lob pass to a teammate or a lofted through ball into space. In order to shoot, press the circle button. If you want to manually modify your shot type, you can take a finesse shot by pressing and holding the R1 button, or a chip shot by pressing and holding the L1 button as you press the circle button to shoot. Note that depending on the situation, you can still get all these different shot types without having to manually trigger them. To press the ball possessor and attempt a standing tackle, simply press and hold the X button. You can also try and take the ball from your opponent by performing a slide tackle. To do this, press the circle button. Let's now take a look at how to use two button controls on set pieces. In order to aim during a set piece, move the left stick in any direction to move the camera around the pitch. The center portion of the screen is essentially your target. During a deep free kick opportunity, you can choose to play a ground pass to a teammate by pressing the X button, or a lob pass further down the field by holding the button down and powering up more than 80%. To take a shot during a free kick, press the circle button. Be sure to watch your power bar though, as the longer you hold the circle button, the more power and elevation you'll have on the shot. If you power up for a shot, you can also move the left stick to add side spin, top spin or back spin. To cross the ball into the box from a corner kick, press and hold the X button. You can also decide to call a teammate short by pulling and pressing the L2 button. Then press the X button to play a ground pass to that player. To take a goal kick, press and hold the X button. Powering up more will result in a high punt down the field. To take a throw-in, aim by moving the thrower with the left stick. Once you're ready to throw it, press the X button.